Alright guys, Ghost of the back with Liberty or Death, and we are moving on to turn 9, try and plot. As you see here, there's the event card, and it is British, French, Indian, and Patriot. And because the Treaty of Alliance was played last turn, all factions went to available, or eligible. So everybody could potentially go. So the British are first. And the winter phase has come in, and they would like to get some more cities, because that's how they base the winter phase, helps base their resources based on the population of cities. But the problem for the British is they have zero resources right now, so they can't actually do any real commands or anything that could help them with that, because you have to pay a resource. So they're pretty much stuck at zero. So they can either take the event for free, which doesn't cost a resource to take an event card if they go here, or they could pass and add two resources. So what they're going to do is pass. The British receive two resources for passing. Since they're at zero, it'll help them out. So they'll move up to two. And that is the end of their turn. So they didn't take a turn, so two factions can still go. And the French are next in sequence. So they're going to not really care about this event very much. Remove all Tories in New York or adjacent space. So they're not going to worry about that. There's actually no Tories in New York or adjacent spaces. So what they're going to do is take a full command and special activity, which means they move over to command and special activity here. And their first command, or their special activity they're going to take is naval pressure. So let's see how that works for the French. Naval pressure. Increase French naval intervention after TOA. So we couldn't have done this until after they did the treaty. Accompanying command, any but French agent mobilization. Okay? So that means accompanying command means what command can they do with it? They can do any of these except for French agent mobilization, because that only could happen before the treaty. So that one can't even be done anymore for them. Location, any cities. Procedure, raise French naval influence one level. French removes one squadron blockade marker from the West Indies and places it on any city, or if no squadron blockades are in the West Indies, rearrange blockades already on cities. Okay. So they're going to take the marker, move it up 1 to 2, which will allow them to take one of their squadrons, and they're going to send that to Philadelphia. So they've blockaded New York City, and they've blockaded Philadelphia right now. So they put some naval pressure on the British in both of those cities. So by doing that, Philadelphia actually has, they don't lose anything, because they don't have any, there was any support in Philadelphia. So if we would have had to, you know, remember, blockades eliminate the support. It doesn't take it off the board, but it just lowers it. But since they weren't having any support there, there's no change in the support. And then the French are going to use March for their actual command. So if we see March here, move French regulars and Continentals. Location, any destination with Patriot pieces or any space if bringing along one or more Continentals. Okay. Cost one resource per destination space. For each space Continentals enter, Patriots pay. Move regulars to an adjacent space or, if in or adjacent to a rebellion-controlled city, to another rebellion-controlled city or a province adjacent. Continentals may accompany French regulars one for one. So what the French are going to do is they're going to take four units from Massachusetts, which is here with the overflow. It's in control of, it's Patriot control, rebellion control. So the overflow's here, if you remember. They're going to take their four units and Rochambeau with them. This is going to cost them one resource, so they go from four to three. And then they're also going to take four Patriot units with them, because they either have to go to a space that has Patriot units, or they have to take Patriot units with them for the move. So they're going to take four Patriot units with them. And they are going to start. They could start in a rebellion ancient, just blah, 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 adjacent to a rebellion controlled city, or another rebellion controlled city or province adjacent to it. So they start in Massachusetts. So one thing that I didn't realize was the way the sea movement works in this game, and that's the one movement that I wasn't sure about that happened earlier. You could take basically any city on the sea, and you could go to any other city on the sea. I believe as long as it is controlled by as long as you have units. Well, you know, the one thing I'm not sure is if you can go through if there's enemy units there. I don't think you can, because none of the options we've had have done that. And for March, it depends on the thing you make. So you have to move to adjacent space. Or, if adjacent to a rebellion-controlled city, so I think it just means if it's controlled. If in or adjacent to a rebellion-controlled city, to another rebellion-controlled city or province adjacent. Okay, so Massachusetts, they're going to move adjacent to Boston. I'm not going to take all of them. We'll just take Rochambeau and then we'll move them. So they start in Massachusetts. They're adjacent to Boston by the Arrow. Then they're going to take the sea, and only the British and the French could move by sea. Not the Indians or the Patriots. So because the Continentals are moving with the French, they're able to go with them. So Boston is rebellion-controlled, and they're going to go by sea to Charlestown, all the way down here, which is also rebellion-controlled. And they can move either to Charlestown, because they can stop their turn in a rebellion-controlled city or a province adjacent to the city they land in. So they're going to move adjacent through the Arrow to South Carolina, where there's two Tories, British Tories. So now we have eight units here, two British Tories. Now, because we outnumber the British, we could take control of the South Carolina from the British, so we'll flip over the token to show it is rebellion controlled, which is sweet. Rochambeau accompanies them. They could take Continentals along with them up to the number of French regulars traveling. So we used four French regulars, so four Continentals came with. The French had to pay one for each place they're going to go to, and because the Patriots went along with them, they also have to pay a resource as well to do that move. So they move from 7 to 6 when it comes to resources. So both factions that move had to pay one resource to end up in that space. So move four Patriot Continentals from Massachusetts to South Carolina and reduce French resources by one and Patriot resources by one. So that's what we did. All right, so now the next faction to go are the Indians. They consider the event card, which shows remove two Patriot pieces in New York or New York City. All militia there are activated. New York, New York City, there are no Patriot pieces, so it's a pointless card for them right now. Limited command, they're going to use a limited command. So because they have to go to the space, they could use the event or limited command. They're going to do the limited. And they're going to do a gather command in Florida. So the gather command for the Indians here, add or recover Indian forces, any neutral or passive province, one resource per province selected, first province if an Indian province is free, place one war party or replace two with a village. If there's already a village there, you may instead either place war parties up to one plus number of villages or move any adjacent war parties there and flip all war parties there underground. Okay, so they're going to move to Florida, which is an Indian province, so this is a gather because it's happening in an Indian province. The first one that they do is free for the turn, so it's a free move for them. And what they're going to do is going to build a village in exchange for two war parties. And because it's an Indian reserve, there's no cost. So they're going to take two war parties out of here. And they are going to build one of their villages in Florida. And that is that. So the war parties come off. And that is now the end of the turn, because there are two moves have been taken, so the turn ends, even though the Patriots haven't been able to go. So the two ones that did actions move, the British move up to eligible, and the Patriots didn't act, so they're still eligible. Which means we move to the cards, and we move Antoine over to playable. And the card that we flipped is the Winter Quarters card. When this card is turned up, stop and swap with the played card. Conduct Winter Quarters immediately. Alright, so basically that means that it didn't matter what this card was supposed to be for this turn. Once this pops up, you actually stop, put it on here, and you do the Winter Quarters stuff that you need to do. And if you look at the bottom of the track here, Winter's Quarters comes through here. You check victory, supply, support, redeployment, desertion, reset. Now we're going to do all this in one more video, because I have a feeling it's going to take a while. So this video is going to be relatively short, but I want to do all that in one video to keep it all condensed into one thing. And I also want to read ahead and learn how to do it so I don't take forever doing it. So thanks for watching for this shorter video. The next video will be the Winter Quarters, which will actually be the last video of the tutorial. And that's about it. So we'll see you then.